By now, I think you all know how much I love science and space. I'm a nerd. It's flat out cool. I think it's cool. Well, I have to tell you about a woman who accidentally became a rocket scientist at NASA. That's a real thing. She accidentally did. It all started when her high school teacher enrolled her in honors geometry by mistake, and things took off from there. Most of us would just be like, okay, look, I'm in the wrong class, so I should move. Like, nope. That's not all, though. She also uses her love of music to break down the most complicated math and science theories into songs to help kids understand, which my kids would love. Let's say hi to Deja. How you doing?
Hi, Kelly. How are you?
I am so good, but I wish I would have been like you in high school. I literally just would have been like, oh, like, I'm not supposed to be here. Like, that's crazy that you accidentally ended up on this career path.
I know. Yeah, so my teacher, she enrolled me. I got a letter in the mail saying that I would be in honors geometry. I was so excited because I thought I earned it. And I went to go talk to her and say, thank you. And she was like, wait, what? You're not supposed to be in this class. And, you know, it kind of hurt my feelings, but I told her, please don't take me out of the class. I want to prove to you and just prove to myself that I can make this happen. And from making that decision, it led me to NASA. So I'm just like super grateful for that mistake that turned into an opportunity.
Absolutely. And that's an amazing thing too. She was like, wait, you're not supposed to be here. And you were like, I can do it.
I can do it.
That's a hard thing. We can do hard things. So I love what you're doing also with music. You write songs, right? To help kids learn?
Yes. So my sophomore year of high school, my teacher challenged us to write a song to the quadratic formula. And I guess on a bus ride home, I was listening to Soulja Boy. So I kind of mimicked his rap and made a rap about the quadratic formula. And it carried me throughout high school and college. So I figure if I can remember that equation from one song that I created years ago, I can use that to help other students learn other topics that may be difficult to them.
Okay, well, you know that I'm gonna put you on the spot. Like, do you have like one, like a little something, one song you could sing?
Oh, yeah, for sure. So I don't know if you ever heard of the order of operations or PEMDAS. And that is basically how you solve an equation. It's you start with parentheses, exponents, multiplication, division, addition, and subtraction. And so it goes, okay, we solve from the left to the right, parentheses, exponents, multiply, and divide, then add and subtract. Now, I don't think they heard me. Let me run it back. Now, please excuse my dear Aunt Sally. We running through these problems like a mathlete. Young Day's on the track with the math heat. What's the order of operations, you ask me? What parentheses and brackets will we start with? We use the round and square brackets to mark it. If it ain't solved, don't move to the next part yet. Then,
oh my gosh! You're stopping, but my whole band, my band's like playing with you, and Lester on drums is like, ask me. He's like, you're a hype guy. Oh my God, that's amazing, Deja. It's really cool how you're doing that and getting kids. You're like the rocket scientist like version of Hamilton. Like, I like it. You're making it cool. I like it.
Exactly. Yes.
Yes.
I'm super excited.
Thank you so much. All right. Thank you for being on the show. And I'm so glad you accidentally got put in that class.
Thank you.